In this video, we will have a look at ESP01x5 module and learn how to program it, which can be really useful if you wish to control only few GPIO pins. So in this video, let's see how to program it and use it. So without any further ado, let's get started. Firstly, let's start with the pinout. This tiny ESP01 module has a total of 8 pins. Starting from top left, they are as follows. First one is ground, second one is GPIO2, third one is GPIO0, fourth one is RX pin or you can use it as GPIO1, fifth one is TX pin or you can use it as GPIO3, sixth one is chip enable, seventh one is reset and finally eighth one is the VCC. If you are not using RX and TX line in your project, you can use those as GPIO 1 and 3 respectively. While working with this module, keep in mind that this module works with 3.3V, so don't accidentally connect it to 5V, it will destroy it. Since this tiny module cost only $2, whereas ESP8266 Node MCU board can cost you around $12, it is a great alternative which is cheaper if you are only using few GPIO pins. For programming, you can use pretty much any Arduino, it doesn't really matter. Or you can even use FTDI breakout board. I prefer this type of FTDI because it has an option for 3.3 volt and 5 volt level. All you have to do is change the jumper position. But if you wish to use Arduino, you can do so. Just head over to my website, link is in the video description, I have mentioned more details over there. Before we can start programming, you will need to make this kind of an adapter board, since the pin on ESP01 modules are not breadboard friendly. Once you have your module on breadboard, firstly remove the ESP01 from the breakout board. And now connect the VCC and ground to the 3.3 volt and ground. Now connect TX of ESP01 to the RX of FTDI and RX of ESP01 to the TX of FTDI. Now connect the chip enable pin to the 3.3 volt and lastly to put ESP01 in programming mode, connect the GPIO0 pin to the ground. Additionally, you can also add a push button between ground and reset, or you can do it manually later. After connecting the USB cable to your FTDI, now open your Arduino IDE and select the port of your FTDI. Before doing so, make sure you have installed the drivers of your FTDI board. Now in the Arduino IDE, select the board as generic ESP8266. If you don't see your board, you might want to check out my previous video which shows you how to install ESP8266 boards on your Arduino IDE. Now open the Blink example under ESP8266. And now all you have to do is upload the code. After hitting the upload button, it will show connecting and then start uploading the code. Once the uploading is done, remove the ground wire from GPIO0 and reset the ESP01 using push button. This will put ESP01 into the mode where it will run the code we just uploaded. Now connect the LED between GPIO0 and ground. And if you have done everything correctly, LED will start blinking. So that is how you program the ESP01. So for programming the ESP01, you have to follow these steps every time and it can be confusing as well as time consuming. So I created this schematic using EasyEDA and converted it into the PCB layout and ordered my PCB from jlcpcb.com, who are also the sponsor of this video. They are truly amazing company. You can order 5 PCBs only for the price tag of $2 for 2-layer PCB. And if you need an SMD stencil for your project, you can add it alongside with your order only for the $7. They not only provide PCB service for 2-layer PCB, but also for 4-layer and 6-layer PCB as well. Now they have even started the PCB assembly service, which can be very convenient if you are working with a lot of SMD components. So check out JLCPCB, link is in the video description. Once I received my PCBs, I soldered all the components, which included female headers, a push button, 110 kilo ohm resistor, and a switch. Now to program the ESP01 using this board, all you have to do is first insert the ESP01 like this and then connect the FTDI breakout board. Now just flip the switch which puts the ESP01 into the programming mode and then upload the code using Arduino IDE. Once the uploading is done, flip the switch again and it will come out of programming mode. Now press the reset switch once and there you go, it works. And you can use this board as many times you want. And now it's very simple to program your very own ESP01 module. So that's pretty much it for this video guys. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you need any more information about this video, then you can head over to my website, link is in the video description. And as usual, don't forget to like this video, share this video with your friends and subscribe for more awesome content like this. And I will see you guys in the next one.